Good afternoon. We're going to be looking at lab number four. This is the fourth week of our ECED 2000 course. The lab this week is referred to as network theorems. There are two particular network theorems that we're going to look at. The first one is superposition. We're going to use a circuit that's very similar, that's very familiar to you. You've seen this circuit before. And this is supplied by two sources. There's going to be a voltage source on the left-hand side. There's a voltage source on the right-hand side. When we are interested in the response, the voltage or current on any particular circuit element, for example, R2, to both of those sources, superposition tells us that we can get that response by looking at the individual responses to each source acting alone. So the way you do this is you take a voltage source and you short it out. And you're left with one voltage source driving the circuit. There's a certain response here. Then you take a second voltage source and short it out, and you drive the circuit with the other source. You get the response. The sum of the responses is the same as the response due to both. That's what you're going to be doing in the lab today. You're going to be wiring this circuit on your board. You're going to be applying one voltage source. You're going to be applying the second voltage source, and then seeing what the response to the individuals are. Superposition is the first part of the lab. The second part of the lab is the network theorems of equivalence. We have a Thevenin equivalent and we have a Norton equivalent. A Thevenin equivalent says that any linear network can be represented by a voltage source in series with a resistor. The Norton equivalent says that any linear network can be represented by a current source in parallel with a resistor. Today, you will be trying to determine the Thevenin equivalent or a given network. The way you do that is you have a pair of terminals, and those terminals can be open circuited, and you measure the open circuit voltage. That gives you the voltage source for your Thevenin equivalent. You put a short circuit across those terminals, and you measure the short circuit current. The open circuit voltage ratio to the short circuit current tells you what the resistance should be. And with those two simple tests, open circuit test and short circuit test, you now can give the equivalent of any linear network. You'll be doing that in the lab today. One of the things I want to bring to your attention is your wiring practice. When you start putting circuits on your protoboards, some of you squeeze all the components as closely together as you possibly can. I'm going to suggest to you, and I think you'll see the picture below, that you should try to spread that out as big as you can, so that you have access to the nodes and you have access to the components, and have a look at that circuit that's shown below, and you'll see that maybe that might be just a little easier to work with. So that's it for today. I hope you have a great time with network theorems, lab number four.